Hi friends, so this is the lecture number 2. Before coming in this lecture number 2, you must go in the first lecture. I have explained you what is the meaning of integration. So integration means you are finding the length, okay? You are finding the total number of points from A to B, okay? So now here I will explain you. You know that in high school, in 8th class, in 10th class, in 12th class, you are using this circle. Actually, this is the circle, okay? So in the circle, every time we say that 2 pi r, that is the perimeter of this circle. Perimeter means circumference. From means you are counting total number of pixel. You are counting total number of pixels from here to here. Okay, how many pixels are here? Okay, in computer science, we are using the language, computer language. How many pixels from this point to this point? Okay, so you are counting total number of pixels. So it means that you are finding the perimeter. Yes, it means that you are finding the length. You are finding the length from here to here. Okay, that is 2 pi r. So how it has, from where it has come? This is the question. Okay, so that is the equation. At first, whenever you are using integration or something, so every time you must have the function. Actually, sorry, you must have the function. This is the function of such type of graph. That is also a graph. This is the function such type of graph. Graph x square plus y square is equal to r square. Okay, so x is the this is the x axis, this is the y axis. In x and y axis we have plotted this graph. R is the radius. R is the radius. Radius, this is the origin from here to here. Okay, and this is d. D means length from here to here. Okay, that is the diameter. So that is the area. Area is equal to pi r square. So how how we got this pi r square? I will also explain you. Here we are explaining you what is 2 pi r. So 2 pi r, it means that you are counting total number of points. Okay, I am writing something. Okay, so from here we have used this So at first I will explain you, whenever you are finding any length, then you will use this formula. The formula is this. I am writing some formula. So this is the way. Okay, that is the formula you will use. Okay, if you want to know that from where it has come, I will also explain you. So this is the point A, this is the point B, and you are, and that is the square root 1 plus u by dx whole square into dx. With respect to dx, you are finding the integration. So y is the function. Okay, y, it means that you will use this one. So y square is equal to r square minus x square. Okay, so now you have to differentiate it. Then after, then you will get 2y dyy dx is equal to, you are getting minus 2x dx. Okay, you are getting 2x. You differentiate this and this with respect to x, so you will get only 2x. So after, then the 2 and 2 cancel, then you got dy by dx is equal to minus x upon y. You got minus x upon y. You can also write this y is equal to minus x upon square root r square minus x square. Okay, so this is the dy by dx. Now you will place this dy by dx here, then you will get integration of a to b square root 1 plus dy by dx is equal to this. This is x square. Okay, then after, then this square root cancel because of r square minus x square. Okay, this value into dx, you are getting this. Now another question. Actually, what about this a and b? Okay, we are finding this r. Suppose this circle, it is in x axis. Okay, this is 0. So distance from here to here, that is r0, and distance from here to here, that is minus r and 0. So we are counting this parameter. Okay, not overall, we are counting only this parameter. Okay, from from 0 to pi, so it will be minus r to r. Okay, from minus r to r, we are counting only this. So only the upper portion. Okay, so 1, then after, then it will come here r square minus x square plus x square upon r square minus x square. Both cancel, x and x, then you are getting
this is, sorry, this is dx, then you are getting minus r to r. This is square root r square upon r square minus x square. Okay, so you have got this one. Now you have to solve this simple formula. Okay, how to solve such a type of simple formula? Okay, so this r, it will come outside because that is constant. Okay, and this r, it will also come outside. Then after that, what will happen? Let we will check. So in this condition, you are getting minus r to r. This r will come outside. Then after then r. Okay, this r come outside. Then after then this r come outside. This r come outside. Okay. So in this condition, x upon r whole square, you will get x upon r whole square. Okay. So after then, you will get both will cancel. Okay. In this condition, then you will get 1 upon square root. You will get 1 upon 1 minus x upon r whole square. I think that everything is correct. We took r square common. R square, cancel. Then you got 1 upon 1 minus x upon r whole square. You got like this. Okay. And we can also write this form dx minus r to r 1 upon, because square root of 1 is equal to 1. You can write a upon b square root is equal to square root a upon square root b. Okay. Square root 1 upon square root this. So we have written like this. Okay, so now you must know that this is also a formula. Use the formula, and this formula, before writing this formula, we must take, because this is x upon r, let x upon r is equal to u. In this condition, what will happen? If we will take x upon r is equal to u, then after then du is equal to dx upon r. Okay. If you differentiate both sides, then you will get du is equal to dx upon r. Now put the value here. Okay. So, and also let, we will also check here what will happen. If x is equal to minus r, then u is equal to minus 1. If x is equal to r, r cancels, then it is 1. Okay. It has changed. And this is 1 upon, okay, 1 minus, this is u square, okay, both are same. Now what about this dx? Here also dx is equal to, dx is equal to r du, dx is equal to r du. Okay, you got this one. So r is the constant. Now after then you can integrate it. So r, that is constant. So now you know that integration of 1 upon a square minus x square is equal to sine inverse x upon a. So you will write here sine inverse x upon a. Okay. So x, here is only x, a means 1. Okay, that is u. So that is the formula we have used. Now we will put this value minus 1 to 1 here. Then you will get sine inverse 1. Okay, minus sine inverse minus 1. Okay. So sine inverse 1 is equal to pi by 2, and this is also pi by 2, but this is minus pi by 2. Then after then you are getting r, this is pi by 2, this is minus pi by 2, minus of minus pi by 2. Okay, so both will add. Then after then pi by 2 plus pi by 2 is equal to pi, that is r pi. So you are getting, this is r pi. Okay, so this is only for upper portion. We have find the length from here to here, and this both are same. So after then the overall parameter is equal to pi r plus pi r, pi r plus pi r, that is 2 pi r. Okay. So what we have done, we have counted total number of pixels from here to here. We have used the integration to measure the length of this parameter. Okay, so by the help of integration, we can count total number of points from A to B. It means that by the help of integration, we can find the length of any function. Okay, this is also function.
we can find the length of any circle, we can find the length of any straight line, anything. Okay, so you have seen that we are using the integration in our real life. Okay, just come in the next lecture, we will solve some questions that has come in your exam. Okay, thank you so much.